welcome to the second video of a three-part series introducing evaluating psychosocial exam components. The video describes how to use the functional pain management intake form. Remember, this does not replace other intake forms, but specifically addresses psychosocial exam components. We are not going to address every question here in this video. I'm teaching you how to use the form and some of the background as to why these questions were chosen. Here's the form. It's a co-branded one, which is available for FPM Society members, so it's a brand with my clinic's logo as well. You'll notice symbols next to some of the answers. These correlate with a key and an action item at the bottom. Most of these indicate what questionnaire needs to be given. You can either look over this yourself or have support staff do this for you. Remember, these questions are not and cannot be perfectly sensitive, so you can poke holes in this and we'll be able to identify some people that need some of these questionnaires that aren't identified by the intake form. But this is a great way to start systematically identifying who needs which questionnaire. The only questions we will discuss specifically here are the ones that require the central sensitization inventory A. If they have at least three locations of pain, or they have been diagnosed or believe they have one of the diagnoses that are under the symbol for the questionnaire, then they need to fill out a central sensitization inventory A. You will note that people who have to fill this questionnaire out often have multiple questionnaires to fill out. This can be burdensome, obviously, after they've been done their intake paperwork and the FPM intake form, and then we give them five more extra questionnaires. It is best to give only the central sensitization inventory A and their functional outcome questionnaire if you give these. Often insurances require them. This way they are only filling out two questionnaires. Other forms that they need to fill out should be given to the patient to fill out at home and bring back the second session. The key with the FPM intake form is that every patient who has pain fills it out. This includes your post-op patients or people who are coming in for acute pain. You can't just give this to people who have chronic pain. We can't pre-select who we give this to. This is a vital point. The people that are post-op that have central sensitization respond differently than those who don't have central sensitization. The person with acute low back pain that is depressed may respond differently than the person who isn't depressed. Obviously, there are a plethora of examples we could give, but you get the idea. The FPM intake form helps prevent that patient coming in with a seemingly simple presentation, but by like session six, you realize that there's so many more layers and it is hard to readjust. It is tough to switch to treatment from that's been geared at nociceptive pain or a biological approach to a psychosocial approach. These are the people that feel like you're telling them it's in their head because you waited to bring it up. The message can then become, I thought it was your tissue, but now I think it's in your head. Obviously a poor message. We need a consistent message throughout treatment. In summary, first, the symbols correlate with the key at the bottom for a questionnaire to be given or a test to be performed or a discussion to be had in the exam. Second, if there are multiple forms, it is fine to elect to give them only the central sensitization inventory A form and then get the other forms when they return on their second session. Finally, give this to everyone who is coming in for pain, not just those you think need it. You'll notice that it asks for their favorite song at the bottom. This is to play when they enter their exam room. If this is a possibility in your clinic, for FPM Society members that want a co-branded form, this can be removed if desired. The next video is the third video in the three-part series addressing what to do with the questionnaires and what to do when you are with the patient.